Bruski Ed here with a lesson about remembering, forgetting, and reminding. More on that following the intro song.
If you want to learn Russian, but your time's not abundant, now new books you'll see is a way to be done. Then sit yourself down and get ready to go. Stay tuned, because it's time for the Bruski Ed Show.
Actually, this lesson is a little mixed up, but we do talk about words for remembering, forgetting, and reminding. In fact, to start things off, here are a couple useful phrases. Я забыл всё об этом. And я про это всё забыл both mean I forgot all about it. So now we get to the actual lesson with sample sentence one. You should change your attitude. A few words will be useful for this translation. Следовать means should or ought to. Изменить means to change or to alter. Взгляд means view or opinion. Позиция means position or attitude. And отношение means attitude. Using these words and a couple of others, we derive the following translations. Вам следует изменить ваши взгляды. Вам следует изменить вашу позицию. And вам следует изменить ваши отношения. It should also be noted that отношения is not the best translation because it is usually used as attitude towards something, as in отношения к. Sentence two is like a whole bunch of sentences in one. He was really tired. The word of interest here is vipram, and vipram means really or indeed. Along with the word for he and the word for tired, the following translation is derived. Он и випром устал. Alternatively, the following translations would also work. Он действительно устал, and он на самом деле устал. If we change the really in the original sentence to very and wish to translate he was very tired into Russian, the following translations would work. Он очень устал and он сильно устал. And finally, if we want to say he was extremely tired, then the translation would be он ужасно устал. The third sample sentence is as follows. That cloud resembles a whale. The focus word here is напоминать, and напоминать means to remind on the one hand and to remember on the other hand. Along with the word for whale and the word for cloud, we get the following translation. То облако напоминает кита. By the way, the translation for that cloud reminds me of a whale would be то облако напоминает мне кита. Also, if we wanted to say that cloud looks like a whale, the translation would go like this. То облако похоже на кита. Additionally, спасибо за напоминание and спасибо что напоминили both mean thanks for reminding me. Moving on now to sample sentence number four. I can't remember the meaning of that word. The key word here is vispomnits, and vispomnits means to remember, to recall, or to recollect. Along with some other words which are probably familiar, the translation goes like this. Я не могу vispomnits значение этого слова. Alternatively, if you wish to say I don't recall the meaning of that word, then the translation would be Я не помню значение этого слова. And finally, we have a little discussion about butter and margarine. He prefers real butter as opposed to margarine. We have a little problem with this translation since both oil and butter translate to масло. And so, in order to distinguish between oil and butter, usually butter is referred to as сливочное масло, and vegetable oil is referred to as растительное масло. Of course, предпочитать means to prefer, and настоящий, as used in this context, means real or genuine. Also, коровы means cow or bovine, and so the following three translations will work. Он предпочитает настоящее масло, а не маргарин. Он предпочитает настоящее коровье масло, а не маргарин. And он предпочитает настоящее сливочное масло, а не маргарин. Be sure to check out the online lesson at ruskiad.com for a bonus dialogue. The focus words for this lesson include позиция means attitude. Vipram means really. Напоминать means to resemble, vispomnits means to remember, and настоящий means real. Русский Эд, signing out now. До свидания!
You made it to the end of your lesson, and watching Русский Эд is better than guessing. The more you learn, the more you know. Come back for the next Русский Эд show.